Jungbauer. Well, I agree that generally speaking, I would love to see us have less intrusion into the business of the school districts. I am a little concerned about the fact that we have students who will be moving from district to district, and we do need some consistency in terms of standards, so that the child that moves from southern Minnesota to the metro area or vice versa is actually working off of an equivalent playing field. And I think it's also true for teachers who may move. In the state of Minnesota, for example, with police officers, they have created basic standards that say these are the base standards. Now, every department can modify those, but I think it's useful for the state to have some input on to what consistent standards we want to see across the board. And so while I also actually support this, I support the idea of doing the evaluations. I really think that is an important part. If we don't measure, if we don't set standards and hold people to them, we won't see exceptionally performing teachers, as we've heard in this committee regularly, that is what we need. But I do think the state does have a place in setting some benchmarks, and I hope actually that we don't set the benchmarks too low. I think we really need to set those benchmarks and raise that bar higher if we're really gonna get exceptional teachers.
Senator Bono.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Senator Jungbauer, I'm concerned about putting the school board in this role. I wouldn't be for that because I think, number one, the principal is really ultimately that's where the buck stops with regard to the evaluation and the continuing contract relationship. And I would hate to see parents who are elected as board members, they are not there observing those teachers. They're not there day to day. You know, if their child had a good or a bad experience, got a good grade or a bad grade, that would affect how they might view tenure. And I think that's a kind of a firewall that we don't want to cross. So I wouldn't be for this particular approach as looking at tenure.
And actually Senator Harrington's points as well. I think Senator Olson and I talked about this a little bit, and that's part of the reason, members, we decided, or Senator Olson decided, to put these ideas on the table and bring a lot of things together as we talk through some of these things. That's a great point. This was a starting point in terms of how do you reaffirm a contract and who should. And to Senator Harrington's point, I believe this year we're going to see a lot of different performance measures proposed. And I think some of those measures would cross over and be able to be put into some of this evaluation. So I'm in agreement with you, Senator Harrington. I think we should put the bar high. And in fact, I think No Child Left Behind and some of the other programs actually reduced things to the least common denominator and brought us down in some of our education standards. So I'm all about you know, raising the bar, getting our kids more into math, science, technology, to really change the way we do education to get kids excited, but to meet them at their level. And I think you'll see a lot of proposals come through this committee that could kind of be joined up with this performance type of thing. So I think it will evolve in this committee, and I think it'll you guys will have some great ideas and come to some great conclusions.